what's next. You know now why to pray, you know how to pray, you know where to pray. Then what remains except to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by actually praying? Go ahead and pray. If you haven't prayed your obligatory prayers, then go and do it. If you have prayed obligatory prayers, then why not pray two rak'ahs as a offering to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to free yourself from the fire on the Day of Judgment, to come closer to Allah with your prayer. These two rak'ahs, these two units of prayer, will witness to Allah about your desire to come closer to Him. They will intercede for you on the Day of Judgment. There will be your witnesses on the Day of Judgment. They will protect you in your grave when you need your prayers and you need your actions in order to protect you from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your Lord is waiting to meet you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala desires to meet you. He runs to you when you walk to Him. He takes 10 steps to you when you take one step to Him. But Allah, this is the Lord that you have, a most generous, kind, merciful, loving, Wadood, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And why is it, O human being, the most noblest of creation, that you don't find the time or the need or the desire to come closer to Allah? Or is it that the world and the whisperings of the shaitan, the distractions and the magic of this world has distracted you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You know, the shaitan comes and whispers in everyone's head. He whispers to me. He says at the time of prayer, he will say, you know, he'll make anyone think about, oh, what about that friend you haven't spoken to? What about that business deal that you haven't closed? What about that family friend that asked you to call him? What about that Facebook page that you wanted to put up a comment there? What about that article in the newspaper that you wanted to read? What about your wife that you wanted to speak to? What about that game on the TV? They're about to score a goal. You know, subhanAllah, it could be Fajr time, and why should I leave my bed that is nice and inviting and comforting and go to the cold water and stand up on that cold morning in order to pray to Allah? But by Allah, these are all distractions. These are all fleeting desires, by Allah, because they cannot compare to the sweetness of the prayer. Forget these excuses. They are not excuses at all. They're just simple barriers, simple questions that have very, very easy answers, alhamdulillah. Why should I pray? Because my Lord said so. How should I pray? It's very easy. My Prophet showed me how to pray. Where should I pray? Very easy. I can just pray wherever I am. And then, therefore, by Allah, what else is left except for you to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and go to your prayer? Remember, my friends, that your prayer is going to be the first thing that will be judged on the Day of Judgment. The first thing Allah will check after calling your name out is, what did you do with your prayers? And if your prayers are fine, then everything else is good. And if your prayers are bad, then everything else is bad. It may be that you are one of those people that find it difficult to find the sweetness in prayer, but struggle with it. Be patient with it. And by Allah, eventually you'll find that your prayer is the most beloved thing to you. And it doesn't matter in whatever state you are. The Prophet ﷺ used to pray in whatever situation he was in. He could be going on the back of his camel in the depths of the desert, in the deepest, on the heat, on the hottest part of the day, and he will say, Allahu Akbar, and he will pray. He could be lying on his bed, tired, sick, and on the sickness of his death, and he would say, Allahu Akbar, and he would pray. Whatever situation you're in, my brothers and sisters in Islam, whatever situation you're in, find the time to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For indeed, Allah is waiting to meet you. If you love to meet Allah, Allah loves to meet you. And recognize this fact, my friends, that the clothes on your body, the glasses on your eyes, the keys in your pocket, the car with which you drive, the food that you're eating, the house in which you are sleeping in, everything is constantly praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at any given moment in time. وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِيحَهُمْ. There's not a single thing on the face of this earth and in the universe except that it is constantly praising Allah, but you do not understand it. If this is the case, that inanimate objects that don't have logic or sense or the mind praises Allah at any given moment in time, what about us noble human beings who understand the benefit of prayer and who will reap its rewards in the hereafter? Should we also not find the time to prayer? Go back to Allah. Go back to Him. Get up and pray. Make wudu and just go do it.